Hi everybody, Sean here. Little video presentation for you to put to rest. When you're trying to learn hand engraving, you may have read books and things, and it's very frustrating to not know if you've sharpened your graver correctly. If you're hand sharpening, you can buy fixtures and then you'll know. And even with the fixtures that you can make, my downloadable ones, I've done a few experiments with them. I've got them working really well now. So this is what your graver should look like. I've tried to draw the same idea, but you can see it has two angles which you create with the same template. And this is the most important bit, this tiny little facet on the end. This creates the, you know, you're holding the graver like this and it creates like a plough action. So instead of diving down and getting stuck, it travels along parallel to the surface of the metal. And I've experimented. I use a GRS graver mark mostly, but I've been pushing graving with this. This is a 90 degree graver and a 70 degree graver, and I've hardly slipped. You can go really deep in coin metal. Probably steel would be tricky, but nickel, buffalo nickel, and a old British bronze penny, no problems. So hopefully you can see there. I'll show you. So this is the 90 degree. That's what it will look like. This is, I won't show you that yet. I'll show you the Bellino style as well, which isn't that important. Like, this is 70 degree. So I'll explain how you would sharpen these. Hopefully that will put it to rest and you'll be able to get somewhere. So that was the 70. This is 120. This shows up a bit better because it's so much wider. So again, you're creating two facets, and they're kind of the line across here is almost straight across. I'll explain how I did it, and you want to keep this pretty short. If you make it too long, like I'll do another, there'll be another part of this video of me sharpening. If you do that too long, it's not so bad when you're learning, but you'll get to know. If you do it too long, it creates a drag when you go around a corner. It kind of drags the back of the graver. But when you're learning, it's okay to have a longer heel. And when you're learning to sharpen as well, you may overdo it a little bit. But as long as you get that kind of facet, you're done right. And then if you're slipping, it's just a matter of practice. You need to practice more. So let me just show. I'll just in case you're confused, when you use the template and it's on the level, it's a level surface, you create one long, oh sorry, that's the wrong one. Right, this is a 116. So when you want to do a Bellino style, you just use, can I see it now? Right, that's the, it's just one continuous angle, and that's just for very fine shading, like a cross hatching. So you're not really carving or engraving, you're just kind of drawing. And you know, I would go with a faceted one there if you're learning. Bellino is, unless you're really good at drawing, Bellino is a little bit more complicated. But Bellino just means, it's Italian for burin, so there's no mystery to it. But most of this thing, you need to get a very polished graver. one of these, normally I use carbide, but I've just experimented this one with some high speed steel, and it sharpens really quickly. I mean, carbide by hand would take you 40 minutes, but this I've done in 5 or 10 minutes by hand with power. You'd have it done in no time, and it works quite well. I polished it up. It doesn't hold as much polish as carbide, but it works quite well. And I'm going to just go over now how to get this result. Alright, so the first stage is you'll download the templates, make your template. I've got another video with a bit of detail how to make it. You've got your material, create a flat section for locating. So the graver, for the first stage, I've done this already, but we'll go through it. The first stage, to create the first angle, the graver needs to be protruding from the surface 30 mm. You can measure it, but I did a 7 mm thing like the Lindsay uses. Just got a bit of a tube, cut it to 30 mm, whatever that is, inches. Let's change to inches. You can decipher. Right, 1.181, whatever that is, inches, but 30 is a nice round number. So that tube is slightly less at home. Anyway, call it 30 mm, and that's how I'll do it now. So have that protruding out slightly and just press that down, and then tighten up the screw at the back. When you make these, I noticed, make sure the hole's all cleared out, because if the hole isn't cleared out, then you've got a bit of wood in there and that's pressing on the graver, and it was crooked, so I couldn't work out why it wasn't consistent. But once I cleared the hole out, and also the bolt that you use that goes through, make sure that's ground off, file it off at a nice 90 degrees, because obviously you want repeatability. So the first stage to get your angle is you're going to do the first grind, which is the first grind is level. So I've got two stones here which are the same level. So the first grind is grind that way, grind, and you'll see till it comes to a point. You can also shape your graver. Can I go in? I haven't got a macro on, so I won't be able to go in. So I've shaped that to a little bit of a point. It's not absolutely necessary, but it's quite nice when you've got a nice slender graver. It kind of it's like a nice pencil you can engrave. You feel like you can engrave with it. So we would go like that, and we'd go through the grits, get it nice and smooth. I go to this is sapphire, so I go polished as much as I can. Right, so we've gone through the grits, and I'll show you next time. Also the face angle, so we've gone down, this is these two surfaces are level, so I've gone right down to as fine as that on the same level. And the face angle, so this is all set up, if this is 30 mm, it will create a face angle. It's about a 45, and it's really nice because the angle is just right. When you're engraving, it's important to be able to see the tip. So you know when you go to grave something, you place the tip on a point. And this you know, I didn't actually, I just kind of chose 45. But I've noticed that it's a really nice, you get a really nice view of the tip. So that's how you would sharpen the face angle. and I can see that's gone to a nice point. Right, so now we are doing the little facets that you saw in the previous video. I'll do those with a sapphire stone. Now we need to raise up the surface that the template goes on, and just experimentation, these are my diamond stones, and that is the perfect height for the angle that I like. You can manipulate the angle, because the angle of the heel, that's the terminology, is relates to, let me put a grave in, it relates to how high you will hold your wrist. So if you are actually engraving something in a very awkward area, curved, or I don't know, there's something in the way, then you can do a higher heel, and then that will facilitate you being at a, going along in a straight line, and you know, still be able to move forward anyway. But for all our intents and purposes, we're raising the surface that we're sharpening on, and this is, let me show you, the thickness of this is 3.79. Yeah, that just happened to work out. I tried it and it worked really well. So let's see if we can right, so you can see it's one single facet, just comes to a point. You know, these don't sapphire has got some diamond paste on there, but you know, they don't cut very quickly because they're so fine. But so I'm raised up that distance, and that way you can just give it whatever swipes, and it's and what I normally do is advantage, I've got a microscope, but you could have a loop, and I just and keep it moving. That's done. I'll maybe do it a little bit more, but once you've got the initial grind, the first grind, you know, you're resharpening, and it's quite an easy job. I'll do a little video after this with me engraving, pushing engraving with this graver. Thanks for watching. Okay, so that was the result of that sharpening. Perhaps this angle could be a bit more polished, but probably doesn't really matter. But this is high speed steel. Oh, you can see it there. Hopefully that'll give. I'll try and take a screenshot, and might help. But I think if you bit of trial and error, you've got the idea there now, you should be able to do it. Right, so I'll just do a little bit of push engraving, just so you can see what is possible. So that this is the 90. And when you're engraving like that, that line looks shiny, but really you've got to perceive it as black. Not only if you fill it with ink, but kind of, you know, especially on a coin, you know, that would oxidize and it would be black, you know, eventually anyway. But don't view a line as white, view it as black. So, let's do some I'll change to the 70 just to show you the difference. You can do right, let's show you what this does. So this, yeah, that's quite a lot of pressure I put on there. I'm surprised myself, it goes quite deep. So I'd say that went down 0.5 millimeter, which engraving is quite a lot. Let's do some fine lines. Every now and again, there's a little bit of leather with some diamond paste. Just, I don't think it sharpens it. It just kind of cleans off. The metal is soft, so kind of cleans the metal. So you can see, you don't really need an engraver. If you're doing coins, you could do quite a lot with that. That's, you know, some really nice. I'm surprised myself because I haven't really practiced push engraving, but I think using the engraver, you're maintaining an angle, and because this is so nicely sharpened, you know, when your engraver is blunt, that's when you're going to slip. Right, so right, let's change to this 70 degree. And it, you know, obviously that'll create an even finer line, but although it's fine, it's still quite deep, so it makes a nice black line. Do you notice what I did? You don't need to do it always, but let's see if I can recreate it again. But oh, of course I won't be able to do it now. What happened? So can you see there? What happens sometimes is you pick up a little wafer of metal on your graver, and you see, no one tells you this, but if you watch engraving, especially if you watch coin die engravers, they're constantly wiping the tip. If you don't wipe the tip, you don't have to do it always, but if you don't wipe the tip, when you go to do it the next cut, you slip on the little swath of metal like a banana skin, and you know, you can damage your so if you see that sometimes, just touch it to your thumb, but sometimes it kind of I'm aware of it and I go to the next one, it just pops off. So this is something to look out for. I'm going nowhere with this. Hang on, I'll just do some kind of some lines that you might use for scroll work, or you say, oh right, oh that was a perfect example there. I had a nice wafer there. So I just placed it down, it fell off. I think I've got the knack of that, but just if you go straight to it, oh, and again, I'm aware, I mean, it's quite time consuming to bring your thumb up every time, so I'm aware of it now, but just something you should, if you notice you're slipping, that might be a reason. Okay, that's help. I hope that helps. Sorry, it's not a very good video. I intended to do a longer one, but just to get it done. Something's better than nothing. Any questions, feel free to ask. Thanks for watching. Cheers, bye.